Hi, my name is Rama Al-Enzy, and today I will be talking about the golf research activity that I worked alongside my partner, Noura. So I'm going to start off with a case scenario. So let's say a new golf player who knows nothing about physics and wants to know how tall, how far the ball would go, and how it would deviate from a straight line shot. One solution is that the person can actually go and figure out how to determine these factors. But this would be a waste of time since they know nothing about physics. Another solution is to get an expert to build a simulation for these players. This simulation would allow the users to input the initial velocity, initial spin rate, and launch angles. This is the problem that we decided to work on this term. So the main goal slash objective of this activity was to analyze the aerodynamics of a golf ball. We decided to analyze golf specifically because we were going to consult Professor John McPhee, who had already done some research about this topic. After we had consulted Professor McPhee, we then decided that we will use this analysis to build a simulation of the ball in Excel or in a closed form space, such as Python. After that, we had also decided that we wanted to validate these theoretical graphs experimentally by using computer vision and LiDAR. This is something that we're currently working on. So I'm going to start off with the aerodynamics of the ball. There are three main forces that are acting on the ball: gravity, drag, and lift. With the help of Professor John McPhee, my partner Noura and I were able to do a force net analysis and use numerical integration to build a simulation that showcased the parabolic motion of the ball in Excel and or Python. This was done by finding the velocity and position of the ball at each time step. We're hoping to use this activity in MTE tool for numerical integrations. During this term, we got the opportunity to actually teach this activity to the base students. So we got the students to use the force analysis along with a numerical integration to build the simulation in Excel. We first got them to build the ball's parabolic motion with only gravity acting on it. Then we got them to incorporate drag and see the effects that it has on the ball. We then incorporated lift, and we had noticed that shown in figure one, the ball started off with a steep slope, and then towards the end it had a parabolic type of motion. And then in figure two, we also noticed that the ball started deviating from its z-axis due to the lift that was acting on it. So what we're currently working on is we are trying to validate that these graphs are actually what happens in real life. So what we are planning on doing is using a baseball pitching machine to launch the angle, to launch the ball at a certain velocity and spin rate, as well as a launch angle. We wanted to, and then we also wanted to make sure that these conditions are what we set them to be. So we'll be using a high-speed camera and computer vision to capture the initial conditions of the ball. We're also hoping to use LiDAR to track the ball's motion in the air to see where its maximum height might be and also where the ball will land. So what I'm going to show you right now is a video that I took off the internet, and I was able to mask the ball in the video so that the computer only tracks the ball's motion through the video. I was also able to computer generate three circles on the ball, and these circles will be used to determine the ball's initial conditions, such as the velocity, spin rate, and launch angles. When it comes to integrating this activity into a course, we're assuming that the students would know about the sport and the physics behind it, or they'll be taught about it. We're also assuming that they will be able to generate this code themselves. What we have done was provide a prototype version of what they will be expected to do. So thank you for watching, and have a great day.